some MAC action. Scott Park, Rockets off, hosting Miami. Game one of the doubleheader they will play four this weekend. Bases juice for McClay Branson in the top of the first. Second baseman Sequin threw to left. Two runs score. She went 3-for-4 with four RBI in game one, as did Mackenzie Moore. Later in the inning, third baseman plates two with her single to right. Red Hawks up 4-0 before the Rockets snag a third out. Their hot bats, coupled with Courtney Verstra's performance in the circle, too much for Toledo. The Miami senior tossed a no-hitter, and the visitors take game one 9-0. The team improves to 28-7 on the season thanks to their 12th shutout of the year, and that was just in game one.
In the second game, a similar story for the Rockets offensively, with a couple of Northwest Ohio products in the circle. Perrysburg alum Bree Pratt got the start for Miami, gave up the lone Rocket hit of the day, struck out 5 in 4 innings of work. Redhawks offense plated 3 runs in the first. They added 4 more in the second before the former Springfield Blue Devil Taylor Turner finished the job for Miami, retiring 2 in the fifth as the Redhawks take the second game 8-0. Allie Cummins impressive in the second game as she went 2-for-2 with 5 runs driven in. BCSN's Mason Lowry and Steve Ronkowitz break down the MAC battle from Scott Park.
Well, not just 2 wins for Miami over the Toledo Rockets this afternoon, but 2 of the more dominant pitching performances that you're going to see anywhere. Courtney Veerstra for the Redhawks threw a no-hitter in game one, and then Perrysburg's own Bree Pratt outstanding in game two, giving up just 1 hit in 4 innings.
Yeah, Veerstra in that first game, she was really kind of off, if you want to talk about it. She had 5 walks in that game, 1 hit batter, allowed no hits, however, 10 strikeouts on the game. She was there when she needed to be. Boy, I tell you what, you talk about that, and then Bree Pratt to come back in game number 2. She gives up a hit in the first inning, and then another Northwest Ohio pitcher, Taylor Turner, comes in from Springfield, comes in, shuts things down in the last inning. Toledo just had a really tough time, but it was because of great pitching from Miami.
Yeah, the Rockets got just 1 hit across both games. A first inning single from Leah Munson in game number 2. And as good as Miami's pitching was, I'm not sure if it was their pitching or their hitting up and down the lineup that was most impressive.
Well, you look at this team, and it does. It has great hitters up and down the lineup. One of those things that Toledo has as well. We've talked about Toledo's great hitting all year long. Good pitching beat good hitting here today, but when you look at Miami, good power, they run the bases well. There's not a whole heck of a lot that this team doesn't do well, and we saw it all here today.
If you're Toledo, you got to put this behind you really, really quickly, but how on earth do you do that, knowing that you're probably going to see Veerstra and Pratt again in games 3 and 4 of the series?
Most likely you're going to see Veerstra again tomorrow. Erin Hunt did not have her best stuff today. We're going to see her inside the circle tomorrow. She's got to rebound. She's got to be the one to be able to come in, shut down this big offense from Miami. If she's on tomorrow, Toledo will have a chance. If she does not have a good game, it's going to be tough again.
That's all from here after 2 big wins for Miami over Toledo.